The ECB today left rates unchanged, and Mario Draghi said that they will decide early next year whether it needs to take more action to revive the Eurozone economy. I'm joined today by ING's Peter van den Hoot. Now, Peter, investors were expecting some sort of announcement on quantitative easing. Draghi spoke a lot about QE and said the decision does not even need to be unanimous. But it does not seem to be coming as early as many expected. Peter, do you think the ECB is trying to avoid political risk? And do you think they will be forced to take some action sometime soon?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, there is indeed, within the governing council, there's no unanimity for the time being. There's a lot of disagreement, especially from Germany. It was quite significant that Sabine Lautenschläger, one of the executive board members of the ECB, spoke out very clearly against QE last week. So there's still some political issues to be settled first. At the same time, the ECB for sure needs some more information on the impact of its previously announced measure. For instance, there will be a new TLTRO this month, and so I can imagine that they first want to see what impact of this TLTRO will be on their balance sheet before deciding on additional measures. But indeed, I think that the political question remains very difficult to solve for the ECB.
How successful do you think the TLTRO auction will actually be?
Yeah, well, the first one was a bit of a disappointment, given the fact that it was came out much lower than consensus expected, and I think that we now will be looking at something around 150 to 200 billion, but probably not more. If we fall short of that, I think it will be certainly a reason for the ECB to announce a sovereign QE in January. If we are above, I would say, the 200 threshold, then most probably the ECB will want to wait a bit longer before embarking on sovereign QE.
And Peter, what did you think about Draghi's comments in regards to inflation?
Well, for sure. First of all, of course, there were the downgrades of both the inflation and the growth forecasts, which were kind of expected, but still, I think that the surprise was that, notwithstanding these downgrades in the forecast, that there was no action at all. Even the inflation forecast for the end of 2016 was downgraded to 1.4% only, which is far away from the ECB target. But on the back of that, there was no specific action now. Now, the thing what Draghi repeated at several occasions was that they definitely want to stick to their mandate. They will comply to their objective of keeping inflation short, close to 2%. So that seems to signal that if there is no change in the outlook between today and the next meeting in January, that the ECB will be trying to convince the Germans, especially, and some other countries that are now still opposed to full quantitative easing. So the fact that Draghi was stressed so many times that the target is inflation seems to mean that that all means are good to reach this target, and if therefore you need sovereign QE, well, so be it. So that was for me very striking. Also the fact that he went at length to explain what all the positive effects of QE could be was also already a kind of signal that they're very close to implementing it.
Peter, thank you very much for your time today. Well, viewers, do stay tuned as there are plenty more just like this heading your way. Goodbye for now.